Our stories used to be so simple. We had a beginning, a middle, and an end. But ever since we moved to this awful city, everything's gotten so confused.
Look, I didn't kill anyone.
And I'm supposed to just believe you. Snow. I just want you to be careful. I almost lost you once, and...
I'm not yours to lose. I'm not going to be an errand girl for Crane anymore.
She looks like Holly.
It's not Holly. It's her sister, Lily.
She was hooking to pay down debt. Eventually, the only people she owed were at her work. You know, that shithole club, the pudding and pie.
My name is Nerissa.
Well, Nerissa, I've got some questions. The open arms.
Oh my God! What is it?
It's Crane.
You know a person. Bigby, you have to tell her.
I know!
What's going on? What did you find up there? You know, other than the...
Not now.
I have a right to know. If my wife is...
Honey.
Shit!
Crane's been... Whoa! Bigby, calm down. Everything's going to be fine, okay? It's going to be fine.
Will someone please explain this to me?
Crane has been stalking Snow White.
Crane might be following Snow. If I can find her, I can... God damn it!
Okay, it's going to be okay. Where did you see her last? Did she say where she was going?
She took Holly to the business office to prepare for the funeral.
Lily's funeral?
Yeah.
How do you know...
I was just at the Trip Trap, and I heard Gren telling some folks about a funeral at the Buckingham Bridge.
The Trip Trap? Are you drinking?
When?
Right now. They were on their way out.
Bigby! Wait!
What?
Snow's been through a lot. There are things she doesn't talk about. Just please be careful when you tell her. And you should tell her. But...
Beauty, I have to go.
Just wait a second and listen. This is important. You know how you felt when you saw that picture? Well, it's going to be much worse for her. Just remember that.
She was truly close to. If you're here, then you were part of a very special circle. People she trusted and cared for.
I'm sorry, Snow, but this is important. I have something to tell you.
Really, Bigby? It's so important it can't wait 15 minutes until it's maybe not at the worst possible time? I'm sorry, everyone. I don't...
Get the fuck out of here.
Holly, wait.
He has no right to be here. Not after what he did.
Look, Holly, I'm not here to start trouble.
You throw my sister down the witching well, and you have the nerve to show your face here? after you lie and you say you need her for evidence?
Holly, wait. That was Crane. Just Crane. He disposed of Lily's body before Bigby could do anything about it. I'm telling you the truth.
Don't cover for him.
But this genuinely wasn't his fault.
You can't tell me Bigby gives a shit about this. Holly, it's gonna be okay.
I'm sorry, Holly. I didn't know he put her down the witching well.
Holly, Bigby's trying in his own way, and I'm sure he has a very good reason for being here. But this one isn't on him.
Why are you here anyway? And don't say it's because you care about this.
Everything okay?
I'm sure everything's okay in Bigby's world. You just walk through the fucking raindrops, right?
Okay, okay, look. Bigby and I are going to have a little chat far away from the ceremony, all right? Look, Holly, I know how this must...
No, you don't know how this must feel. You have no idea. Don't fuck anything up. Don't bother anybody. And when the first sign of trouble comes, and it will come because you're a goddamn walking trap for it, I want you the fuck out of here. You hear me?
Of course. You won't even know I'm here.
Let's just continue, okay?
This is such total fucking bullshit.
Let's go, Holly.
It's your turn to talk.
This better be wildly important. It's been hard enough making a connection with these people. When you pull this kind of stuff, it just resets the clock.
Crane murdered Lily.
What?
I followed a lead to this shithole motel, the Open Arms. Crane had a room there, and he's been taking prostitutes, or at the very least Lily, and making her look like you while he was, you know. The bed was covered in blood. I know it was him.
This is... I don't even know what to say right now. I really don't. I'm just trying everything I can right now to not picture it. To not picture him.
I'm sorry, Snow. And I'm sorry I had to be the one to tell you.
You're sure this is what happened? This is what he's been doing? Because please, Bigby, don't confuse things. Deposing Crane would be the next step. And if we get this wrong, it would mean more than our jobs.
Crane has been taking photos, Snow. Lots of photos.
Photos that show him...
He's been recording his visits with Lily.
God. Look, let's go back to the business office. I doubt Crane's there at this hour, but we need to talk. And this isn't the place. Snow? Narissa? What is it?
I'm sorry, but Holly's asking for you.
Are they starting the burn?
Yes. Everyone who spoke should really be present for this part. She's kind of distraught. You're not leaving yet, are you?
2 minutes. I don't mean to be,
No, I understand.
It's just that something's come up.
No, I get it. Take your time.
It won't take long.
How'd it go? At the motel? Did you find anything? No?
Yeah. Lily was killed there. It was an awful mess.
Oh.
I'm sorry.
Narissa!
Yeah, coming!
Constable? Wait, wait, wait. Easy now, girl. You know how this goes. The first thing in a visit, you say, how do you do? How do you do? That way, it's proper.
Now is really not the time for whatever you jerk-offs are planning to do.
Well, isn't that the thing of it? Plans. Except it isn't our plans you should be concerning yourself with. I'm still hurting, you know, from our talk in the cell. And I'll be honest, I'd love nothing more than to carve a sweet poem right into your face for the suffering you've caused me. But I am a professional, and we're here for a job. We'll snip to the chase for all sakes. A little bird told us that you're fitting to go after Crane. And you see, we have an interest in that particular boy. So you leave Crane alone, and we'll leave you alone. Just take a little vacation is all. Don't even have to go anywhere. Just sit in your office and whistle to heaven for a few short days.
Are you working for Crane? Did he send you?
No. See now, you're already asking too many questions. Just pay attention. So what's it gonna be? We have a deal? You leave Crane alone and we leave you to yours? Brother, speak your mind. Fastly now.
Just don't hurt anyone, D.
That don't sound like a yes to me. Always wanting to do things the fun way.
Ladies, gentlemen, invertebrates, please, rest easy. This is not...
What the hell is going on?
What's happening?
Very sorry to impose, but we only had a deal to work out with Bigby. And we're unhappy to report that things did not go as smoothly as planned.
Bigby, what is he talking about?
Never you mind that. It ain't any of your...
What deal?
Settle down now. Yeah, everyone just stay where you are, nice and natural.
I'm not making any deal with you, so just get the fuck out of here and leave these people alone.
Nah.
What did I tell you? What did I say?
Ollie?
You think you motherfuckers could come here uninvited? You think you could just fucking interrupt Lily's funeral?
Calm down, darling. It was just a simple business transaction.
You fucking freaks are not getting away with this.
Polly, don't move.
Yeah, listen to your lady, love.
Ollie, let me handle this.
Yeah, let's spare all the fuss. It's just a dead hall.
I'm gonna kill you!
I got it, damn!
I did as well as I could to take out the buckshot, but there's still some shards left embedded in your shoulder. They'll eventually worm their way out on their own, but until they do, you're gonna be sore.
Bigby, Dr. Swinehart was appointed Fabletown physician for a reason.
It's okay. There's only one thing you have to take away from all this. Take it easy. Don't go looking for any more fights. Keep strain off your heart. And try and get some rest. I had everyone that got wounded sent home. Holly refused to let me see where she lived, so I left her and Grendel back at her bar with a dose of juniper and spring water. Just remember what I said. The stitches won't hold up if you continue to act like you normally do. Everything in moderation. And eat more chicken. Your blood pressure's through the proverbial roof.
Business office. I know, I'll have to call you back. The town is starting to find out.
Well, I'll leave you two to it then. Miss White, Bigby.
So, to recap,
Crane watched me through the magic mirror uncover his room at the Open Arms, and then he smashed it so we couldn't use it ourselves to go after. And we know this because Bufkin was drinking in the rafters. That about cover it?
And once he puts all the pieces back together, it'll be easy to catch Crane. So, I guess that's the plan, currently. But I don't know.
That's the plan? Just wait for the mirror?
It's all we have right now. What the hell is going on? I don't know what the Tweedles get out of this. I don't know if Crane sent them. I don't know if... I mean, this is gonna sound crazy, but do you really think Crane did it? Everything points to him, I get it, but do you really think he killed those women? Because it's just... it's incomprehensible to me. He was a conniver, a coward, a liar. And I'll always hate him for that. And I'll hate him for how he held me in his thoughts. But murdering prostitutes?
Ow!
Everything okay over there?
Yes, Miss White. I just cut myself on a piece of the glass. Nothing to worry about.
Thanks for tonight, by the way. That could have gone really terribly. I mean, even worse than it did. I'm glad you were there.
I just feel bad for Holly, really.
Yeah. Time heals everything eventually. At least, I hope so, for her sake. Can I, ask you a question? It's kind of personal. And I don't want to offend you, but after tonight, it's on my mind.
Sure.
It's just, when stuff hits the fan, like it did tonight, it feels like before we came to the city. It feels kind of like home. And I've heard it said that maybe in some tiny little bottled up way deep inside, you kind of enjoy it when things go wrong. Because it gives you an excuse to just, you know, stop pretending.
So what if I do? You think we're broken or something? Is that it?
I don't know. Maybe we're just not cut out for this world. We can't eat each other's hearts anymore, Bigby. This can't be like the old days. We have to make it better.
Guys? We have a problem.
What is it?
I can't finish the mirror. It's missing a piece.
What do you mean, missing a piece?
Yes, it's not here.
Bufkin, are you positive it's not here? Maybe it just slid under one of these cabinets.
No, I'm sure it's not here. I checked every corner. I saw Crane pick something up after he smashed it. I'm sorry, I didn't realize what it was until now.
Well, the mirror can't work unless it's whole.
Well, that's not entirely true.
Or what, Bufkin? What? We sit around and wait until it mends itself? We have no idea how long that will take. We're just gonna have to do this the hard way.
I'm just saying, waiting is an option.
No. We can't depend on the mirror. He had to have left something that tells us where he's going. He's a neat freak, but he was never that smart.
Smart enough to take a piece of the mirror. We can still solve this ourselves. I know
that. Never mind that. Come help me look.
Anything?
No, but there's enough notes and stuff here to take all night. Maybe check that stuff there.
Crane ever do any work?
Only when Cole was around. What is it?
It's the key to his room at the Open Arms.
You still haven't told me what was in there. I want to know. I need to know.
I think it's better if you don't know.
Don't coddle me, okay? I've seen more than you know. There's only so much you can repress, you know? Come on, let's keep looking.
There's a page here that was torn out.
Oh, yeah? Bufkin, do you know what was here?
It's a ring, at least. Every magical item not retained in the armory is assigned to someone in Fable Town. It must be this witch he is going to see.
Wait, what? What witch? What meeting?
He called up somebody. He said he needed to see his witch, or that he would need to get to the witch for that, whoever that is. Well, yes, it sounded like the one he got his, glamours from. I'm sure it's about this ring. They must have it.
Why not mention this before?
No one asked me.
Bufkin!
And I'm hungover. I'm sorry. He set the meeting at 2 a.m. tonight.
What's going on? Is the mirror fixed yet?
Bluebeard, this isn't the time.
Is the mirror fixed or isn't it? You called me to...
I called just to see if you knew where Crane could be, and that was it, okay? And I'm sorry I said anything more than that.
Well, you did, and I know. The cat's out of the bag. So, can we find the dull pervert or not?
I tried
this
to, but...
This isn't your concern.
I don't know why Snow told you anything.
He and Crane talk all the time, okay? He was a resource, albeit one that turned out to be useless.
We hardly talk all the time. Besides, why spend time on such guttersnipe?
Look, this just isn't the time. He took a piece of the mirror, so we can't use it.
The only thing we know is that Crane's going to see a witch at 2 o'clock.
A.M. or P.M.?
A.M.
Listen, Bluebeard, you're not a part of this.
I don't think you're in any position to turn away help.
Define help.
It's okay. We can all work together, right?
Look, we know that Crane is going to see a witch, and it's to acquire a magic ring.
What's the ring?
We don't know what it does or who it's assigned to since Crane tore its page out of the book.
This farce was your ridiculous idea for a plan. I mean, who put you in charge in the first place?
Fixing the mirror was the most logical
thing. You're a secretary. He's the sheriff. And none of you were chosen to run this office. Who elected you to make these decisions?
Nobody, but that
Who
doesn't...
Who elected her to spend my money?
Well, I've been doing that unofficially for years now.
Unofficially is not officially.
I'm heading up the investigation, okay, Bluebeard? That makes this a moot point.
And somebody needs to run the business office while he does so.
Well then, excuse me for having the Commonwealth in mind.
All right, let's just look on the bright side. We know Crane is going to see the witch that's been supplying him black market glamours.
Thanks to me.
And that he'll be there at 2. So that gives us a few short hours to find out who it is and where they live and get them all at once.
And a few shorter hours, the more you babble about it.
We haven't been the ones babbling.
Yeah. Just point in the direction you want me to check first.
Since Lily used the glamours, she'd have known who the witch was. And I don't think Holly's burned her things yet. It would probably have the address or a phone number or something.
And Bigby is free to go there if he likes. But I think the question you should be asking is just what do the two Tweedles know about this?
It doesn't matter what they know. After tonight, they'd never go to their office.
They're not smart enough to try and go anywhere else.
The Trip Trap is the better option to track the witch down. That has to be our focus.
I don't really care what you two do. I'm going to his apartment.
What? You can't just go up there.
And why the hell not?
We already looked for the key, remember? I don't know where it is.
Then I'll pick the blasted lock! I've wasted enough time waiting for the mirror to find him. I won't waste any more.
You just can't go up there alone, all right?
I've no interest in nicking his drapes, my dear, if that's what concerns you.
What concerns me is you traipsing through possible evidence.
Oh, now it's evidence. Before you had no interest, and now it's a crime scene.
We can't just let Bluebeard run amok in Crane's place.
Ha!
He's after something. I just don't know what it is. We have to find the witch, Bluebeard, since that's where he's going.
Or the sniveling weasel chickened out. Never went anywhere. And is upstairs right now in his pitiful penthouse, crafting a fort out of couch cushions. Look, this is how a smart person would do it. So this is how we're going to do it. Wherever you go, I'll go to the other.
I don't like you going anywhere unsupervised. He's up to something. I don't know what it is, but we don't have the time to really worry about it now. Where are you gonna go, Bigby?
So you leave Crane alone, and we'll leave you alone.
I'd love to join you, but there's some business I need to attend to.
No, I'm better off dealing with things alone. I don't need sympathy and I don't need charity.
Crane's place is right here. I should check that out first.
Perfect. And I'll go to those two imbeciles' office.
Crane's penthouse number is 1903. Let me know what you find. I hope you know what you're doing.
Snow said Crane lives in 1903. Anyone in there? Crane? Missed him. There's gotta be something about his witch here. This hasn't been used in years. I forgot. He used to teach in the old days. Because I love you. Crooked man. This is all I could get. I'm afraid Snow will start to notice. I'll have the rest for you next week. Ichabod Crane. What's going on here?
useful. Same brand we found in the open arms. Math, science, history. If I had to guess, this shit didn't work. I've never seen him that excited. Guess things have changed. Someone in there. Okay, well, there's gotta be an easier way.
Jack? Wow, it is just unbelievable running into you here. I mean, of all the places. This weather, right? A little damp, I guess. But, you know, some people like that sort of thing. You know, I've always wondered, do you get that wet dog smell when it rains?
Don't play dumb. I'm running very low on patience tonight.
Okay. I know what it looks like, but before you go jumping to conclusions, Crane pays me to water his plants when he's gone. It's a stipend. But you know I need the work. I wouldn't do it for free, right? You know me. So, anyways, now that I'm done...
I don't see any plants. Hey!
Okay! You got me. Just take it easy. Don't make a big deal out of this. I'd like to keep all my teeth.
You better tell me why you're really here.
Okay. I heard Crane was leaving town. I figured he owed us little people a parting gift. Or just me a parting gift.
You heard?
I have my sources, okay? You see how he lives. He doesn't need any of this shit. A little Robin Hooding never hurt anyone, right?
Do you know where Crane is? Have you heard anything else about him?
No. Should I have? What else do you want me to say? I got bills to pay. Not like Crane's gonna use any of this stuff. Is this really fucking necessary? You know, this tortured lonely pig eater bit's gonna get old eventually. Don't you get tired of it? I mean, what are you even doing here? Are you just wandering around Crane's apartment? I mean, what's the point?
That's not something you need to know.
Sure. Well, looks like you've got it covered. Anyway, it was really nice catching up with you. I mean that. Bigby, I believe you're, blocking the doorway there, if I could just, squeeze through. You know, on second thought, it's actually funny I ran into you like this. I think I can help you out. If it's information you want, I'm the guy to ask. I know things.
Somehow I doubt it.
You're looking for Crane, right? Well, I don't know where he is, but what if I told you I know who might know where he is? Word on the street says he's got a witch in the city. I can tell you who she is, if you're interested. Information comes at a price, though, but I'm sure you already knew that.
All right, tell me.
Let's make ourselves a deal. I tell you about Crane's witch, and you forget you saw me here. One hand washes the other sort of thing. Wipe the whole incident under the rug. Come on, what do you say?
Fine, you got a deal.
Perfect.
Now Tell me where I can find this witch.
Strong grip. Her name is Auntie Greenleaf. Crane's been trying to keep it under wraps for years. If you're looking for Crane, she might know how to find him. The thing is, I don't know where you'd find her, exactly.
You gotta be fucking kidding me.
But even a name is a good start, right? I mean, that's more than what you came in with.
Right.
I'll keep my eyes open for you. If I find anything else you might be interested in, I'll be sure to let you know. I think this arrangement can be beneficial to both of us down the line. It was just lovely running into you, Bigby.
Hang on a second.
Oh, come on.
The white deer.
Do you always talk to yourself like that? The witch uses the white deer on everything. It's her symbol or trademark, I guess. Figured I could sell these at the Lucky Pawn.
The Lucky Pawn?
It's one of the Crooked Man's places. I work there sometimes, when I need some stability. It's a pawn shop. Get it?
Yeah, yeah. You find any more of these?
No.
You nervous about something?
What do you mean?
Look me in the eye and tell me you didn't steal anything else. Come on, Jack. That it?
Bigby? Are you still here?
You're done here.
Fine by me.
Who are you talking to? What's he doing here?
Evening, Miss White.
Good evening. What's going on? Jack?
Well, since Bigby seems to have lost his ability to speak, I'll be happy to explain. I'm here to offer my services.
What does that mean?
I had some information about Crane and his witch I thought the business office might be interested in.
Oh. What did you find out?
Her name is Greenleaf.
Auntie Greenleaf.
But he doesn't know where we can find her.
Great. Crane's meeting her at 2 a.m.
And Snow, I found a note with some money attached. Crane has been embezzling from Fabled Town.
Of course, because why half-ass being a complete sleazeball? Do you think this is tied to the murders? I mean, I guess it doesn't matter yet. We still have to find him. Crane's meeting Greenleaf at 2 a.m. And we have no idea where she is. We're going to cut it close as it is. We have to figure out where he's meeting her.
I'll figure it out.
You should try Holly's. She still has all of Lily's things.
If she hasn't burned it already.
There's still Tweedledee's place. We know they're involved. And we know that's where Bluebeard went. Where do you want to go? We don't have much time.
I'll go pay the Tweedle brothers a visit. I'm sure they know something.
Okay. I'll give Bufkin the name and hope he finds something in the records.
Let me know what he comes up with.
I'll be in touch. I hope you'll do the same.
We'll catch him, Snow.
Hang on, Jack. I want to talk to you.
Oh, hi, Bluebeard. Oh, no, I'm sorry, big guy. You can't come in. Yeah, because the thing is, and I don't know if you'd heard, but I'm a third-degree black belt and, you know, whatever. So I wouldn't take any chances, hombre. Last guy who messed with me got his marbles kicked right through his abdomen, all right?
Excuse me.
Oh. Hi, Sheriff.
Flycatcher.
What brings you here?
What the hell happened?
I'll have it cleaned up soon. I'm sorry.
Bluebeard was here.
He was looking for something. I don't know what. He said it was an official investigation. But how was I supposed to know if he was telling the truth? When I wouldn't let him in...
Shit.
Found what he was looking for, I guess. It's just super annoying. I just finished cleaning.
You know where he went?
No. I don't know what he wanted. I didn't see what he did after... I'm really sorry, Big B. Was he telling the truth? He said you sent him, but I don't know. I just thought he was lying. I'm not supposed to just let people in here. But then he got mad, saying, oh, just terrible things.
Don't worry about it, Flycatcher.
Oh, I'm gonna get fired. Crane already let me go from the Woodlands.
Is that why you're here?
He said I just got in the way. Told me to get lost. The twins offered me a job here working the night shift, so I'd have something. What do I do now? It's nice, you know, quiet. I come in and clean up. They're usually pretty nice, understanding.
Well, Crane is gone now. I can't see why he couldn't come back to the Woodlands.
Really? That would be... thank you.
Come by the business office. I can't make any promises.
Right, of course.
Look, I'm running out of time. Ah, shit.
Is everything okay?
I gotta go.
What? Where?
I'm headed to the Trip Trap. Just call Snow and tell her what's happened, okay? Can you do that for me?
Okay, I guess. And I'll ask her about that job, all right?
Sure, sure. Take care of yourself, Fly.
You too, Sheriff Bigby.
She's asleep, you fucking idiot.
Hey! Hey, look, Woody, it's the sheriff. Well, come on in, buddy.
Grant.
What? He's a traveler. A weary traveler in search of some hospitality, right?
Yeah, sure. Thanks.
I want a drink. Anybody else want a drink?
Grant, Swinehart said you shouldn't mix
you
it.
You think I give a fuck what that fucking guy says? Or what you say?
Grant, really, you shouldn't drink right now.
I can't hear you when you mumble.
Swinehart told me that Holly was here. I need to talk to her.
Holly's asleep in back, but you won't be able to wake her.
Really? The doc gave him both barmesidal ambrosia for the pain.
Look, the deal is, if you resist going to sleep like I am right now... it gives you a very, very, very nice high.
And he said that he shouldn't mix it with alcohol.
Yes, he did. He certainly did. But let me tell you something. I haven't felt this good in a long time, fat boy. And I feel like having a drink, okay? That funeral back there, that was a shitty fucking send-off for a pretty okay lady.
Yeah.
You weren't fucking there. Talking to Bigby now, okay? Can't say you being there helped things much.
Gren, don't start nothing.
Who's starting anything? I'm not.
You think I shot up the place? It wasn't my fault.
They got away, though, didn't they? Whatever. It's all right. I'm too out of it to get into it. I want to clear the air. We're all in this dung heap of a fucking shit town together. We're all gonna have a toast. All of us.
Fellas, I'm here for one thing. To look through Lily's belongings and get out of here.
Now, yeah, right? Yeah, I know. And I want to help you, okay? And I will. But first, indulge me. It'll take 2 seconds.
as a show of good faith. And after, we'll all hunt and peck for Lily's shit or whatever.
Grand Bigby didn't come here to get loaded with you.
I don't want to get loaded with him. To the dead.
All right, now help me.
Gren, the doc said you needed to rest.
How many times you fucking gonna warn me about it, huh? You're not my fucking mother, so just get off my back!
I said I was sorry, all right? I can't do anything about it, it's done! What more do you want? What else can I fucking say here?
I don't want anything from you, Woody.
I absolutely cannot babysit you dumbasses right now. So end whatever this is, so we can just move past it.
Oh, I forgot. You haven't heard the news. This walking lard cake was paying Holly's sister to let him fuck her behind all of our backs. And Holly had to find out going through all of her sister's shit. What fun that must have been. Trick after trick of this fat ass and Lily.
I didn't plan for that, all right? And our thing, whatever it wasn't a big deal. It wasn't. I never fucked her when she was snowing. I didn't know nothing about that.
No, but you knew Holly would flip out. And you knew for a damn good fucking reason.
You know what? Fuck this. I don't need this shit.
Oh yeah, that's it. Now you're teary-eyed. You were always such a lowlife. I don't know why I never realized it till now. What do you think about this fucking loser, Sheriff?
He can think whatever he wants. I don't give a shit.
No, that's okay, because I'll tell you what he thinks. He thinks you have to pay chicks to touch your fat, hairy ass. That's what he thinks.
Wait, wait. I've got some questions for you.
What possible questions could you have for this piece of shit? Everything's a problem when I want to talk, but when the woodsman's about to leave, it's, oh wait, I have questions.
What do you want?
When you saw Lily, did she ever mention anything about a witch?
No. We didn't talk about work.
All right.
Gren. I don't know where Lily's shit is. Check Holly's room, I don't know. But I wouldn't wake her if I were you. Sleepwalkers and trolls. I think that's the rule. Maybe, ogres, too. What a day. Am I right, Sheriff? What a fucking day.
Bigby, bar's closed. And excuse me, but I'm not in the mood for entertaining. But what the fuck? I know you're not gonna leave. You do what you want. You always do what you want. Do you even give a shit about us? The strays? The ones that aren't in that fancy high-rise. Those of us that gotta work for a living.
You may not believe this, but yeah, I care about everyone who came over.
I don't know about that, Sheriff. You're friends with your friends, and we ain't friends. Why'd you even come here? There's nothing here to investigate. I can't be any use to you.
I'm tracking a lead.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Be honest, Sheriff. Why are you going after him? The guy that killed Lily. You could have quit a long time ago, but you're still going. Why? Did they give you this job for a reason? Or was this the only thing the business office would let you do? I thought so.
Getting your glamour on this day, and one of these has to be the witch. Auntie Greenleaf. Gotcha.
Hello, this is Snow White calling. I'm looking for Bigby. Is anyone there? Bigby, if you're there, pick up, okay?
Snow?
Oh, thank God. Tell me you found something.
I got it, Snow. Her address was here with Lily's things. It's on, White Plains Avenue, 1284. It's an apartment complex.
Great. Let's get going. Crane's meeting her in a few minutes.
All right, let's go. I don't want to miss him.
I'll meet you there.
All right, I'll see you there.
Bigby! I just got here.
Yeah, me too. It's number 23. I haven't seen it yet.
We're late.
Yeah, I know. This is it.
All right. How do you want to do this? Hear anything?
If anyone's in there, they're being awfully quiet.
Wait. What are you doing?
What does it look like?
Don't just kick it in. We don't know what's on the other side. Let's just save the last resort for last. Make sense?
Fine, okay. What would you have me do instead?
I don't know. Knock? I mean, we have no idea what's behind this.
Hello?
Hi.
You woke me up.
Sorry about that.
Is something wrong? I don't think I've ever seen you before.
Who are you?
Rachel, who are you? Just so we're not strangers.
Dearie, I'm the big bad wolf.
Bigby.
Really? Wow. I've heard about you.
Have you?
All about how the woodsman cut you open, fed you rocks for dinner, and then threw you into the ocean. And you can't even swim! Did it leave a scar? Can I see it? Are you and the woodsman friends? I heard somewhere that you guys are friends. But I mean, I wouldn't think you'd be friends after something like that.
Actually, kid, just call me Bigby. And this is Snow.
Oh. Okay. Is there anything you need? I'm not allowed to let people in.
Is your mother at home, currently?
I don't need a babysitter. I can cook dinner all by myself. Is there something you want? I don't think I can really help you. Maybe come back in the morning.
Rachel, do you mind if I take just a quick peek around?
We'll be very quick, and he won't touch anything.
I've been here all night. Nobody's been here. Okay, Bigby, I'm gonna trust you not to break anything. Don't get me in trouble.
What are we looking for specifically?
Crane. He could still be here. That your mom?
Uh-huh.
Your mom a hunter?
Oh no, she never... That was found in the woods around Dick's Mountain, I think.
It's pretty rare to see a burner like this.
Dowdy. That's how we like it.
What is this?
Mommy uses that to carve her trinkets. It's from the old world.
Trinkets? Like glamours?
Not here.
There's no one here but me. No one's been over all night, so...
He's just going to check. It'll only take a moment.
There's nothing that looks like Crane was here either.
Nothing?
See? Where do you buy your clothes?
At a store.
Oh, my mommy makes all of mine.
Let me guess, big band or classical?
Honky tonk.
No accounting for taste.
I saw a spider over there, yes. How much longer do you think it'll be? Do you like broccoli?
The Butcher.
What's that?
A package having to do with someone called the Butcher. It's empty. God damn it.
I shouldn't say that.
Nothing.
I keep getting whiffs of that aftershave of his.
I do too.
Can I go to bed now, please?
Is that a glamour tube?
Mommy really doesn't let anyone play with that. Trust me, I've tried. Oh, no, 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 no. Please, 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 just put that back exactly where you found it. No one is allowed to play with
that. It's all right, honey. Bigby's not going to break it.
No, you don't understand. She will freak out if she discovers I've let people in here and let them touch her stuff, okay? She checks all the time to see if things move. I don't want to get in trouble. Look, I'm already grounded.
I'm not gonna break it. I just want to open it.
No! Put it down! Please, don't! This isn't what you think! You gotta believe me. The guy isn't here, I promise!
It's gonna be okay, Rachel.
Please, I'm begging you. I don't wanna get in trouble.
Anti-creep.
Hurts when you do it that fast. What?
You picked the wrong night to lie to me. No more lying, no more ring around the rosy, no more bullshit non sequiturs. You're done. It's over. You're gonna tell me what I wanna know right now.
All right, start explaining. And from the beginning.
I was born in the woods to a jackal and a...
Where's Crane? Speak quickly!
I ain't a fortune teller, Wolf. I have no heavenly idea where he went to.
You have to know something!
Unless you want a recipe for owl stew, there's nothing I know that would help.
Huh. That's funny. I distinctly remember...
remember telling you just now to not fucking lie to me! I don't think you get it. I'll gladly illustrate how much trouble you're in if you keep up the Babe in the Woods routine.
I have a lot of bullies in my life, Mr. Wolf. One more won't tip the kettle. There's powers at work here beyond your pathetic authority.
Whatever it is, Greenleaf, whatever it is that's keeping you from saying something, you have to forget it.
We can protect you, okay? Whatever it is you're afraid of, we can make sure that it won't come to pass.
You have no idea what's going on, do you?
Okay, you know what I think? I think we've been more than patient with you. This witch has been selling illegal glamours that continue to undermine everything we've built. She's harboring a fugitive that took advantage of it, and now she's resisting every attempt to make things right. I frankly don't give a crap if she's afraid for her life. We can at least make sure she never hurts us again. We're destroying the tree.
No! How dare you come in here and threaten to take from me the one thing that... That tree is ancient. It's part of the family, and it's the only thing paying for this shithole apartment. And the Fables, who can't afford the glamours from you, come to me for help. Without them, where do you think they could go?
Don't give me that. You're making money off of other people's misery. Two Fables are dead because of this crap. It's too dangerous leaving this stuff with her.
You think I like being the old woman in these stories? The men are heroes, the ladies are whores, and the old hags like me get to watch everyone they love die.
We have very different ways of handling our fate.
Very different means to handle it, too.
And I don't use it as an excuse to wreck people's lives.
I'm sorry, Sheriff, but please.
Greenleaf Snow's right. The tree has to go.
No! Look, I'll tell you. Crane was here. He was here, and he left. He went to the pudding and pie to try to use my ring on the girls over there to get information.
What does the ring do?
He thinks it's the ring of dispel. You know, that it will pierce the protection around the girl's speech. He says pulling the truth out of them will prove his innocence. It won't, though. Damn thing lost its power decades ago. Just please, you can catch him if you leave, okay? Just leave, and don't burn my tree. I'm begging you. Don't destroy it, please.
This whole story of yours better check out.
It will.
We can always come back later.
Even after I told you everything?
That's it? She's off the hook?
Come on, we have to get to Crane while he's still there.
Hey, Greenleaf. Don't think this is over.
I won't.
No, it's nothing you need to concern yourself with. I don't think so, at least.
Shit.
Hold on. Oh, did you miss the spot? Mr. Clean, come to smash up the rest of my place. Oh, I see. Come to audition, you bitch.
Where's Crane?
Ichabod Crane? What would that nerd have with a place like this? Hey, you can't just go in there. We have a problem.
Tell me who did it. Just tell me who did it. I know you know.
Mr. Crane, please. She can't help.
I know you know what the plan is. I won't be held accountable for this.
I can't. I'm sorry.
You both know what's going on. Just tell me.
Don't move, Crane. You're under arrest.
Oh, my God. Bigby, I had nothing to do with this. I didn't do anything. I promise you, I didn't do anything. These girls, the girls, they'll back me up. I just have to get this stupid ring working, that's all. They can't talk because of that spell, but once this ring gets through, I'll know what's going on and this whole thing will be over. That's all, please. I'm innocent, completely innocent. Wait, can't... You have to just give me the chance. This will work, I assure you. Everything will be solved. I went to... You... Damn you, come on. Please. Tell me who killed her.
My lips are sealed. How many years?
What?
How many years has this been going on?
Too many. But I didn't kill those women, Bigby. Please, I had nothing to do with that. I just... Oh, God.
We found the photos of you and Lily.
I know. That was... I just love you, Snow. I love you, and I'm sorry I'm not Prince Charming, okay? I'm sorry I didn't cheat on you and run away to Europe.
You don't love me, Crane. I know what this is. I've seen it before. It is not love. Bigby? I don't think he did it.
What?
Look at him. Do you really think this man murdered these women? He wouldn't be brave enough. Not to put his stamp on the world like that. He's a disgusting coward, not a murderer.
Snow, of course he's guilty. If you'd seen the room...
I don't need to see the room.
There's a lot he has to answer for.
There's a lot we all have to answer for.
This is different, Snow, and you know it.
You said you found evidence of him defrauding Fabletown, of using our money for his own ambitions. That's one thing. But don't you have doubts he's a murderer? We've both known him for so long.
I can't believe I'm hearing this. Did you see how he was acting when you showed up?
Yes, I know how this...
Why would he even come here if he wasn't covering his tracks?
There's nobody else that's even remotely... He's the prime suspect. There is nobody else.
But why? Really, think about it. Because circumstantial evidence is one thing, and I won't kill a man for that.
Everything points to him. Do I have to go down the laundry list? His room, his girl, all his fucking lies.
And all of that is perfectly fine, except that there's no real motive.
Snow, I...
And no evidence that says anything except he was in the same room at some point in time. He embezzled millions from Fabletown, Bigby. That's what I have to care about. And that's enough.
I was gonna pay all of that back.
Snow, why are you defending him?
I'm not. I'm defending the order of things, Sheriff. You can hate him. I do. But I want him brought in for what he did to this town, and not killed by you for personal preference. Ichabod Crane, you are under arrest for the misappropriation of Fabletown funds. You have the right to counsel, the right to depose witnesses, but as of right now, you're coming with us.
And for suspicion of murder.
No, Sheriff. This can't be Greenleaf again and again, behaving however you like, acting without constraint. You have to respect this office, Bigby, and you have to respect me as its leader, starting now.
You think you have what it takes to run that office? You think I didn't make sacrifices? I made sacrifices. And you won't be in that chair 1 minute before you have to give up something you care about just so the wheels don't fall off the goddamn wagon. I did the best I could with what I had. And the town took everything it could out of me. If I maybe took a little something back in return, then so be it.
I have no regrets. Better save your energy, huh? You're going away for a long time.
Oh, no!
involved in the preposterous schemes.
What are you saying?
What you got there? Look, it's recently come under our attention that you're, how shall I put this, attempting to claim what is the personal property of the Crooked Man. He's about yay high, 120 odd pounds, pissed his sheets until he was 14. Sound familiar?
I haven't told him anything.
Not now, not now. Shh. The grown-ups are talking. Guys, speak English.
You're interfering with Fabletown
business. No. That's not how this works. How this works is you are going to walk Crane over here, like a good doggy.
It wasn't my fault.
Shut up. You're interfering with official Fabletown business. Step aside.
Tweedledee, what's the, you know, that thing the Mundys call me?
What?
My nickname. You know what I'm talking about.
Bloody Mary,
that's it. Thank you. And do you know why they call me that? Because some of them, they think it's funny to have their little sleepovers and go into their little bathrooms and say my name 5 times in the mirror. They find it less funny when I actually show up and feed their lungs to the family dog. And I do that for a hobby. Like golf, to relax. This is my job. I like my job.
You can fuck off if you think you're getting him.
I told you he'd never just give him up.
Fuck it.
Bigby?
It just didn't know when to end.
You know, you wouldn't think silver bullets would work on anything but a pure werewolf. But as it turns out, it's just going to be case. Right, Wolfie? I mean, hey, look, I know it sounds ridiculous, but really, guys, can you argue with these results? Because I know I can't.
Wait! Stop! Just take him, okay? Take Crane. Just stop, please.
Yeah, I don't know.
Snow, don't do this.
It's your lucky day, kid. The Crooked Man says it's okay with him. Hello, Ichabod. Got a stomach ache? Oh, and just between us girls, Crane ain't no killer. I mean, look at his face. Couldn't stick a pig if his life depended. Nope, not like your boyfriend. Well, this is gonna be a beautiful relationship we have with you guys. Really, I mean it. I'm jazzed about it. Out with the old, in with the new. Long live the queen. I'm sure we'll be in touch. See you around.
He's lucky to be alive, and he won't be next time if he keeps going like this.
This is getting worse by the minute. We don't have time to sit around and wait for their next move.
I'll get things under control.
Woody, I'm not gonna tell you again.
Back off, dog. This doesn't concern you.
What'd you want to talk about?
I just wanted to, about last night.
When people hear what you did to Dom, they're going to think you've gone back to your old ways.
Don't hold out on me, Jack. You've always got some angle.
Not this time. I know when a mark's not worth the trouble.
Do you?
Don't make me come down there to deal with you. I don't want it. You don't want it. Then again, you don't have much choice at this point, do you?